PowerPoint 2013 comes with a number of new themes that you can use for your presentation, but quite often you're going to want to use your own corporate theme. In PowerPoint 2013, there's a new coloring tool called the eyedropper, which makes it much easier to pick the exact color from your logo and add it to your presentation design. Now I'll show you how you can use the slide master and the coloring tools to create your own professional corporate design.
Here I have the beginning of a company meeting presentation where no corporate theme has been applied. I want to create an attractive corporate theme that I can use so that the presentation will look like this.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
On the title slide, I want our corporate logo. And throughout the presentation, I want to use our corporate fonts and colors. Every time you create a new presentation in PowerPoint 2013, you're presented with numerous themes that you can use for your presentation. You can preview the theme and try different color layouts, and you can click to see what various slides in the presentation would look like using the theme. If you like one of these themes, you can use it as a starting point for your own corporate design. In this case, I'm going to start from a blank design. I'll click on the Design tab to see the starting point. Even though I've created a presentation using a blank design, it actually uses a theme called Office Theme. To create my own corporate theme, I'm going to open up the Slide Master. To open up the Slide Master, go to the View tab and then click Slide Master. You can think of the Slide Master as the backbone of your presentation. Whatever changes you make to the Slide Master will be applied to your presentation. In PowerPoint 2013, the default slide layout is widescreen. If you normally use a projector that doesn't support widescreen, you can change the layout to standard. The Slide Master contains a number of different slide layouts. This one is for the title slide, this one for the content slide, and so on. I'll go to the top slide, which is the master slide. Whatever I apply here will be replicated to all other slide layouts. I'll click Insert, Pictures, and then select our company logo flower. I'll place the flower in the top right corner of the Slide Master. As you can see, automatically all of the different slide layouts are updated. Next, I want to add an orange background shape behind the title. I'll click Insert, Shapes, and select a rectangle. I'll draw a rectangle at the top of the slide. I'll click Shape Outline and select No Outline. Next, I'll insert a right triangle. I'll hold down the Shift key as I draw it to make sure to keep two angles at 45 degrees. Again, I'll click Shape Outline and select No Outline. I'll click Rotate and select Flip Vertically. I need to position the triangle perfectly, and the new alignment guides in PowerPoint 2013 help me do that. Now, I want to merge these shapes into one, so I'll mark both shapes, and on the Drawing Tools Format tab, I'll click Merge Shapes and then Union. Now I want to change the color of my newly created shape so that it goes in line with the colors of our logo. I'll right-click and select Format Shape. In the Format Shape pane, I'll expand the Fill option. Instead of using the solid fill, I'm going to choose a gradient fill. I'll leave it as a linear gradient. I only need to have 3 gradient stops, so I'll just mark one and click Delete. Then I'll move the second one more towards the middle. I'll mark the first gradient stop. Click the color icon, but instead of selecting one of the suggested colors, I want to pick a color from our logo type. In PowerPoint 2013, Microsoft has introduced the eyedropper so that you can easily apply colors that you have elsewhere in your slide. I'll click the eyedropper, and as you can see, my mouse pointer turns into a little dropper with a color square and a text box showing me the unique color combination for that color. Here, I'll pick a dark orange color and click. I'll do the same for the second gradient stop, picking a medium orange color, and finally, I'll click on the third gradient stop and select a light orange color. Okay, now I'll just close down the format pane. As you can see, the shape is covering the title, so I need to send the shape back. I'll right-click and select Send to Back. Then I'll just move the text box and resize it a bit so that it's better aligned to my shape. To change the color of the title, I'll go to the Home tab, and in the Font section, I'll change the color to white. Now I want to change the font of the title. You can easily see what different fonts would look like using the live preview. To match our corporate identity better, I'm going to use a font called Forget Me Not that we have in our logo type. This font isn't included in Windows by default. You can purchase and download fonts from a number of sites online. I normally use a site called myfonts.com, where you can easily search for fonts based on certain criteria. It's important to note that in order for these fonts to display correctly in your presentation, the fonts need to be installed on the computer. So if you send the presentation to someone who doesn't have the font type installed, it will be replaced by another font. Now I want to change the font for the slide text as well. I'll mark the text, and here I'll select a built-in font called Sego UI Lite. I also want to change the first level bullet. I'll place my marker on the first row, click Bullet, Bullets and Numbering, and then Customize. And then I'll just select a simple dash and click OK twice. I want the title slide to have a different look and feel so that it looks like this. First, I'll change the title color by marking the title text box, and on the Home tab, I'll change the font color to a dark gray color. I'll also make it a bit smaller by clicking the Decrease Font Size button. I'll click the Slide Master tab, and in the Background section, I'll mark the option to Hide Background Graphics. I'll insert our full logo by clicking Insert, Pictures, and selecting our full logo. I'll resize it by pressing Shift on the keyboard while pulling the corner to keep the proportions. I want to have the same orange shape here, so I'll go back to the Slide Master and copy it by pressing Ctrl-C on my keyboard. I'll paste it in by pressing Ctrl-V. I'll just resize it a little bit for the title slide. Now I need another orange shape for the bottom. I'll click Insert, Shape, and again select a rectangle. I'll draw it at the bottom of the slide. To copy the same color formatting of the top shape, I'll mark it, go to the Home tab, and click Format Painter. Now, I'll just point to my shape to copy the formatting. There! Now we can close down the master view to see what this presentation looks like. To close the master view, click the Slide Master tab, and then Close Master View. There! Now the presentation looks much better. The final thing I have to change is the color theme. To apply a new color theme to a presentation, click the Design tab, and in the Variants drop-down, select Colors. Here I can select among a number of predefined color combinations with colors that work well together. Here I can also choose to create new theme colors. I'm going to change these colors, and again, I want colors that work in harmony with the orange color that is dominating the slides. You can find tools online that help you find matching colors. Here I have a site called Generated, where I have entered our orange color, and it has given me colors that go in harmony with that. I'll just choose to darken the colors a bit, and then I'll note them down. I'll click the first accent color, But unfortunately, I don't have the eyedropper here. So I'll just have to enter the RGB codes of the colors from the site for each of the accent colors manually. When I'm done with all the colors, I'll give the color combination a new name, Corporate Colors, and save it. There! To apply this color combination to the Slide Master, I'll open up the Slide Master, click Colors, right-click my newly created color combination, and click Apply to Slide Master. There! Now that I'm happy with the corporate theme, I'll close down the Slide Master and save the theme. To save a theme that you created, click the Design tab. Open up the Design Theme Gallery and choose Save Current Theme. I'll give it a name, Corporate Theme, and then Save. Now I have the corporate theme design saved in the design library, and I can easily apply this to any new presentation I want to create. Every time I create a new presentation, I can access the theme by clicking Custom and then selecting Custom Themes. If you click the little push pin next to your theme, it will be available on the first page every time you create a new presentation. There! Now, in less than 10 minutes, I've created an attractive corporate PowerPoint theme.